Well, it's Water Cooler Wednesday.
And it is here today. Danny Bruns from 98.1 The Max. Steve Connolly with 99.3 Guess FM and Miramichi Golf Course. And our very own Austin Onnit. Guys, welcome. Good to see you all this morning.
Good to see you again, guys.
Let's do some talking. Rapper Snoop Dogg has released a new video, and it immediately has gone viral, not because everyone loves the song, but because of the controversy surrounding it. It shows a mock shooting of a clown dressed as President Trump. Now, some are defending it as artistic, while others say it's totally inappropriate, no matter what your political affiliation. So, Danny, what do you think? Especially, as you know, Snoop Dogg will be in Memphis in a few weeks the Beale Street Music Fest.
Yeah, I don't know if that's very good, but I don't think anybody should have that with the president of the United States. You should never joke about shooting the president of the United States, and especially if you smoke a lot of marijuana, because to me, you're just putting a bullseye on your own head. So if you don't do anything illegal, then maybe you could joke around a little better. But I think with Snoop and his past, he should be a little more quiet and be more like Willie Nelson.
Mm. On the road again. Okay.
Did you watch the video? It's pretty disturbing. It's dark and ugly and weird and just a. Remember Escape from LA with Plissken and those guys? Just looking at that ugly side of life and then putting in the president thing and shooting him, and it's just disgusting. He's going to have guys in black suits knocking on his door, possibly.
So obviously, you're saying he should not have done it.
I don't think so. And just the whole thing. And you know, he's going to play the Beale Street Music Festival, and the words are going to be wafting over Tom Lee Park. If you have young ones, I wouldn't bring them down there that night. To be honest.
Austin, how do you see it?
I'm a big believer. You know, naturally, where we work in the First Amendment, and I agree that you can say up to a point what you feel, with the exception of shouting like fire in a crowded movie theater when there's nothing going on. You can say what you want to, but you can't escape the consequences of it. And I think that what he's done has done a very good job of kind of opening the door to say, well, if he can do it on the video, then I can do it for real, which is what some people may be saying out there. And I think that opens a very dangerous door.
Okay,
moving to our next topic. Well, according to a new study, phone separation anxiety is not only real, it's almost as bad as PTSD. Well, how do you feel when you're separated from your phone?
Steve, where's your phone?
You know what? I left it in my car leaving this morning,
and
I
went, separation.
Oh, gosh, I left my phone. I got about down the driveway and went back up and got it. And there is that separation. However, this study, to compare it to PTSD, anybody who has ever suffered that, I'm sure, and we haven't, I don't think, but if you have, I just can't imagine that comparison. Maybe, losing your homework or something, but not PTSD. That's a pretty strong comparison, and the anxiety of that, I can't imagine it matches losing your or being separated from your phone.
Got you covered.
Austin?
Well, again, working in the business that I do, I'm glad to be rid of it for a few hours, if at all possible, but it is most of the time when I leave it behind, it's overcharging in the weather office right now. I still get a bunch of phantom buzz on my hip to where it's like, is that checking? Do I have to ring? There's no, that's not ringing on there, so I don't think it's even anywhere close to PTSD.
All right, Danny.
I agree 100% with them. I mean, if I'm with my children, I know they're okay. I love being away from my phone, but to compare it to that is not fair, I don't think.
Okay.
All right, we'll keep it going.
All right, so right now, Disney's new Beauty and the Beast movie opens this week after much anticipation and controversy. Now, the director stirred the pot when he said there will be, quote, a nice exclusively gay moment in the movie, including Gaston's friend, LeFou. Well, at least one U.S. theater won't show the movie. Some countries are censoring it. Yesterday, the Catholic Church in Singapore urged parents to explain to children that consequences of the lifestyle portrayed. What do you think, Austin Onnit?
Yeah, I think it's a movie. I don't think there's going to be too much of anything in the way of major problems with that. I don't particularly see a problem with that. It's the sign. It's the way things are right now. The characters of every type are being portrayed that way, and that's again what the entertainment business is moving towards.
Why do we have to talk about everything? If everybody would just been quiet about it and not brought it up, I think it's okay. I think everybody's trying to make a big deal out of maybe nothing, or there's always been gay characters. You just had to figure it out for yourself. No?
Figure it out, Steve.
Oh, yeah. Here we are talking about it.
You want the censored version or the uncensored version?
The priest, quoted in the story, said, you know, parents, you deal with it with your kids and, you know, that issue. If you watch Saturday morning television, Family Channel and that kind of thing, I mean, you see it all the time, and I don't think it's going to be a big shock to kids. And, you know, if you want to go with your kids and try to explain everything, then more power to you.
All right. And finally, two coworkers in Britain who share the same email account did an experiment. Now, one's a man, one's a woman, and for 2 weeks they switched their signatures. The man was shocked, saying it was, quote, hell, and that clients constantly questioned his decisions that were condescending. One even asked if he was single. So, meanwhile, Nicole had the most productive 2 weeks of her career posing as Martin. So, what does this say about where we are as a society, Danny?
Danny, how do you sign yours and how do people perceive your signature?
Well, I'm very lucky because my name is Danny.
Yes.
And I have a mouth like a man.
It works in our favor because Corey is a guy's name and a girl's name. And sometimes when I send emails out, you know, if you don't know who I am, you might think it's a guy.
That's so exactly right.
Thing. Yeah.
I don't think it's great. I don't think it's fair. I don't think it's right. But play the game and you'll see. You'll get a lot more done.
I mean, is this truly an issue? Is this something that women experience when they find out it's you're a girl and
it's a difference. Is it a different tone?
I wouldn't know that until seeing things like this, though.
Right.
Because
right.
You just don't know. Because why would we? We haven't done an experiment.
Well, I'll become Stephanie and I'll check it out.
That would be interesting. Hello, Stephanie.
Thank you.
Austin.
With a name like Austin, you don't really have too many problems and things like that. But I've seen stuff like that happen ever since I've been in the business, to where you have meteorologists are considered weather girls and they are not treated as the same professionals. Even if you have a degree or two, you do not have that same amount of respect that you get, especially from the male population. It's like, well, you're just a weather girl. I'll just explain the weather to you. It's like, okay, you have a master's degree. I'll explain it to you this way.
Right.
So there's a lot of things like that that happens. As a society, I think that we haven't come as far as we should have by now, and we have a long way to go.
Unfortunately so. And before we wrap up, Steve, we understand that you have something very important that you would like to share with us this morning.
Please,
put it on the tape.
Is it on the screen?
Are you becoming a grandpa?
Yeah. I picked today to announce that. Actually, yeah, on Friday the 31st, last day of the month, Miramichi is going to reopen after a refurbishing of the golf course, and the whole day is to St. Jude. Every dollar we make goes to St. Jude. That should be fun. We're going to have a party in the patio. Robin the Rage is going to be playing up there. Want more information, go to Miramichi.com and join the party, and it should be fun. And, you know, it's a whole day for St. Jude. T.G. Shepherd's coming and a lot of other
big
T.G. Shepherd is coming.
Are we invited?
Absolutely.
I think so.
I sent you the invite.
Okay. Thank you, guys. Appreciate you being here.
Thank you.